LJ for president.
Sing the rock to the vibe, don't stop. Sing the rock to the vibe, get it, come on,
get up. Get down, get up out of your seat. Get up, get down, get up and move your feet.
Come on and rise,
shake your hips
and wiggle your thighs.
Get up,
let me see.
Wanna see?
Wanna see the time better come alive?
Get up,
you ain't too old.
You ain't too hip.
Get up, I ain't asking for a cartwheel.
All I need in the horn monitor is horns. All right, so when we play, make sure it's loud enough for you. Do your thing,
let's do it the right way.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's Quentin Denard. What's the name of that song, Quentin?
Which one are you talking about? Love for Christmas?
Which one?
You talking about Love for Christmas or?
No, the one on the CD, the Motown Motor City Hits.
Oh, same song. It's called Nothing Compares.
Yeah, it's a beautiful song, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
And this is Quentin Denard. How do you find it?
You can go to MySpace, which is just type in Quentin Denard, two I's, Quentin Denard the second, and my MySpace page, YouTube page to come up. You can also Facebook me at facebook.com/QuentinDenard2, and it'll come up too.
Justin, you know, we didn't ask you this good question, because we know you like the part. We know you love the character. But how would you feel if production decided to only cast you for the role between the ages of 16 and 30, since you look so young? How would you feel about that?
You know, honestly, I would take any great opportunity, especially being a part of this great experience, even with athletics and anything that I did, I was always...
So you don't mind if they just give you, let's say, typecast you for a certain age? You don't mind that?
Honestly, I really don't. I really would love to be a part of it.
Now that you've met the real Dramatics, what do you think?
To me, honestly, they're all wonderful people. They all bring their own piece to the puzzle. And to me, without Ron being there, it is a major piece that's gone.
You're a young man. How did you hear about Ron Banks? Well, basically, have you ever heard of Ron Banks before you were casted to play the role by JT from College Hill, when you were casted to make that YouTube trailer of the Dramatics? How did you, you couldn't have possibly known of Ron Banks by name alone, did you?
Honestly, I didn't. And that's was the thing for me. I knew that they sung certain songs in the rain, which you see is...
You knew the Dramatics sang songs.
I knew the Dramatics as a whole group. I didn't really know them individually, but as I got a part of the project, I got to know them individually, especially Ron Banks. And educating myself on who he was, and I just fell in love with the way he was and the way he carried himself. And that's
okay, so you learned to like him.
Yes, I learned.
And you've learned to find similarities in your guys' character or personalities.
Yeah, he's a very smooth, kind-hearted person. Really wasn't. I think to me, he showed his love through his actions, and he's a very smooth cat. Me. In my sense in life, I carry myself the same way. To the Dramatics.
We're in Sacramento. Doing another beautiful show. Putting it down in a dramatic way, as we always do, in honor of my dad, Vinnie Mays, mom, and Ron Banks. God bless and thanks for the support. I thought for that movie is coming soon.
What about the Dramatics? How you feel about them?
Oh, they're beautiful, man.
Are you here to see the Dramatics?
Yeah.
All right. How long have you known about it?
About 2 weeks.
2 weeks? But the group itself, how long have you known about it? Yeah.
How long have I known about it? 2 weeks.
What? love the dramatics. It's...
40 years?
Oh, 40 years. I'm about 70-something years. I'm 74.
Amazing. Ladies and gentlemen, this is another dramatic experience. We're here with your dramatics. I'm Greg L. Glass. And I'll be your host, brought to you by Do Good Dog Productions and our friends in collaboration, Rider for Life Production. Oh yeah, and always into something entertainment. Hey y'all, watching this video. I am with the Dramatics. I am so thrilled. These guys have traveled the world. They've been on practically every stage that's available and worked with just about every bit of talent out there, at least this half of the century, the 21st century. Listen, how many of you can say that you've been in the same room with James Brown, let alone work with James Brown? Man, I ask LJ Reynolds, I go, LJ, have you ever met such and such? And he always responds, I mean, I used to sing with, produce, wrote a song with, perform with, such and such. I'm like, you know everybody. God, these guys are phenomenal. Hey, you know what? Enough of that gibberish. Let's get on with the interview.
Ladies and gentlemen, the moment you've all been waiting for. These are the Dramatic Players. Coming to you all the way from the Motor City of Detroit. We have five fantastic young men. The great Lord brought it down to bring nothing but everlasting love. They're gonna put glide your stride, pep in your step, and love in your heart. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together. These are the legendary Dramatics.
I was tap dancing at the age of about 5 and 6 years old with about 30 young girls. And me and my sister, they incorporated some singing into the show while we were tap dancing. And a lot of the people, mostly white audience, started throwing money on stage. And me and my sister knew right then that tapping is something that we needed to get away from and start utilizing our singing abilities. And so I've been singing for food ever since. Even if you were capital, I can never let you go. Cause I ain't gonna remember those stars in the sky.
Well, my name is Donald Albert. I'm the first cousin to Mr. LJ Reynolds. And boy, you know, you're talking about a lot of fun around the house, singing. Oh, I could sing. You made a mistake. You made a mistake. Growing up, you know, singing in church all the way through elementary school, to high school, stayed in choir and drama and things like that.
I'm just an average guy. I was known to have a little talent. Junior high and high school, entering into high school, Smokey Robinson managed a group that I sang with.
You know, coming up, I always sang in little groups in the neighborhood, things like that, and I was younger, so my voice hadn't developed. So everyone wanted me to sing, you know, the Ron Banks and the Eddie Kendricks. And I remember one day hearing Marvin Jr. from the Dells, you know, give your baby standing ovation. And people like that, I was like, that's, you know, that's a man. Thank you, baby.
My father was a great singer. He just didn't take it as far as I did, to the extent that I did, but my father was a great emulator of different artists. I studied him and I took his thing and took it to another level. Like Curtis Mayfield. But I guess you might say, you know, the way Curtis sang, feel the only way I'm a fool for you. I just want you to stay. Luther, so amazing how I love you. You know, everybody got their own little blueprint or fingerprint or voice print of the way that they sing.
I was brought into the group through Ron Banks and Albert Wills. He's the founder of the Dramatics. Ron was 13 years old. We played on the same baseball team. We went to school together. We were came up in the same neighborhood as Smokey Robinson.
I met Ron Banks and Willie Ford. At the time, the Dramatics had a hit record called What You See Is What You Get. It just ain't my game.
Come on now. Come on, y'all. Put your hands together with me.
What you see is what you get. What you see.
I happened to be signed to the same guy. Don Davis said, well, who do you think can come in and sing this stuff? He said, some guy named, Ron said, some guy named O.J. I said, L.J. Reynolds? I said, yeah, L.J. Reynolds. I met him in New York and he sung to us. He's with this group called the Chocolate Surf. He said, I got him signed. So they called me and said, hey, would you come and sing with the group temporarily? I said, because I don't want nothing to do with groups anymore. There's too much stuff going on. I need to pursue my own career. So I got into the group, to make a long story short, to go on the road with them so they could make some money. And I tried to sing it. They say, sound as much like Ouija as you can. So I sounded like Ouija for the length of that tour. Then they say, well, listen, we have to cut a record because he ain't came back yet. Would you come back and sound like Ouija as much as you can on the record? So I came back and I did the Devil's Dope album, which my first song was Fail For You.
Like a wheel,
rolling round and round. Rolling down here. So I did that record. And then they said, listen, we got to do the TV show. This guy's, it's not, you know, he's not coming back. So I said, okay, I'm going to do this TV show and I'm not doing nothing else. So we got on there, we did Soul Train and we did Fail For You, which became a top 10 single. And from there, and then we did another tour and another album, and pretty soon I couldn't get away.
I was with Flores previous to being with the Dramatics. And then it came up one day where I was with TFO. Through TFO, I met Ron Banks. Brought LJ down to see me, performing with the Floaters. And LJ said, yeah, okay, that's straight, we like him. And the job came open, and shortly after that, they approached me and said that I want to come to the Dramatics. And they liked for me to. And I said, I always wanted to and I love you, but I'm with these, I got to show some loyalty. I'm with these guys and there's only three of us now. So I told the Dramatics, no, I can't do that, man. He was like, girl, you always wanted, but she didn't pay you no attention. And it didn't look like you was going to ever be with her. So you moved on with your life and you found somebody else that was good to you and cared about you. And y'all got tight. And then all of a sudden, here this girl that you always had a thing for come back around. A year came and gone, exactly like basically 11 months. She came back and offered me the gig again. At that particular time, I had already been saying, well, dang, maybe I need to move on. I'm not really getting where I want to get to. I didn't waste no time. What time is rehearsal? And then I went there, and Lenny put me under his wing, and LJ took me under his, and Ron, and Willie was just, he was just perfect family.
I actually met Ron Banks, let me think about this now. I met him down at United Sounds one day, and Ron Banks walked in, and heard my drum playing, and he told me, he said, you know, Locke, you kinda good. Ron Banks called me, and I wasn't interested in the gig. At the time, I had my band, him and Tony Green, they must have talked about an hour and a half about me taking this gig. And then finally, I just said, okay. I've been with the Dramatics now about 17 and a half years. Long before I got with them, the Do What You Want to Do album, I played about four or five songs on that particular album.
The first show at the Apollo Theater, you know, and my part came up and might be my girl. And I went out there, I was nervous for the first time in my life. And my hand was doing like this with the mic in it. Ron had to walk out there and grab my hand literally and stop it. And I sung the part.
Ron Banks, one of the most thoughtful brothers that I could really think about as of today. You know what, I've got to say, LJ is a particular guy, and I'm not mad at him. He wants it exactly where he wants it at, and he wants it played the way he wants it played.
Very aggressive about my music and what I want to do. Now, I don't have a hot temper, but when people, if some people are not talented enough to to get me the things that I want. They kind of feel like I'm hot-tempered, but I'm not hot-tempered. I tell you, I'm not!
Dramatic has a special project going on, like a TV show or album. Squirrel came in and became very instrumental. He was a Dramatic all the way. Even when he quit, he was, whether he realized it or admitted it or not, he's Dramatic.
He was the one who was doing a lot of the routine for the Dramatic. He was a well-rounded person, and he was very talented.
Oh, man, you're talking about a wonderful, beautiful person. He's another guy that, when you talk about a great brother, all around, I could sit down and talk to him. Times when I'm down, I can pick up the phone and call him, and he lifts my spirits right up. Man, he was fabulous with dancing.
He could dance. He could let it go. He could make steps. He was fluid. He was acrobatic. He was the best shaker in the world.
I actually see some people have God-given talent. Okay, and I believe he was one that had a God-given talent.
Tony Hester was a genius. He wrote some magnificent songs. And it just seemed like he had us right in the pocket.
I really want some. I really want you to see me better. Yeah, I got to walk on that door. I can't stand it. Think about it. You in the rain. You in the rain. And me in the rain. Me in the rain. About the driver's train.
Dramatics have to stay young.
When we did Doggy Dog World, for instance, we sold 8 million singles. The video that we did with Snoop Dogg got the MTV award. We began to have a young white fan base, and that was, what, 15 years ago? Grandma called me Spanky. Spanky with the little rascals were always trying to control everything. He said, Spank, what you think? So we listened to it. I said, it's the Doggy Dog World. And Ralph said, the Dog World. Ooh, it's the doggy dog world, the dog world. You know, it's your world. That was my whole thing around my. So after we got the background on, and then we did the little lead parts, it all comes together.
Yeah, LJ, we feed off each other pretty good. You know, we believe in writing stuff that you know is the truth. I don't care what situation you're talking about. And me and him get together and we get the dialogue and stuff. Even if it's just through conversation and through the part of actually sitting there trying to write, we bump off each other and we put it together and make something special happen.
When his heart is cold, you say you don't love.
Experience, where you got the Dramatic experience from?
Missing, loving, wish he was still here.
It could be a lonely feeling. It could be something you miss, but it's also something you have to accept. And you try to make things sound the same as much as you can. A lot of people say, have you replaced Ron yet? No. You know, Ron is, I'd like to make you. He kind of talked you, but you said you were, with a little laugh, but you said you, he's kind of laughing in there. And everybody don't understand that. You just ain't gonna be able to take anybody and stick up there and let them sing. And nobody, no one will be wrong.
The last 8 years I've been singing in Las Vegas.
I'm producing my CD and I'm doing some collaboration and co-work with LJ. Happy feeling like a change.
Brand new record company called MotorCityHits.com. The first record, we released a compilation CD that featured the Dramatics with a song called Bad Girl. We had the Four Tops on the album, the Miracles, Carla Cook, Sam Cook's daughter, Wenzel Kelly did a song, Quentin Denard, who works with me as a producer and as an arranger and as a sound man, very super talented young man. We all got together and collaborated on that compilation CD, which also featured a song called Come Get to This, that was originally recorded by Marvin Gaye. Now this record stuck out like a sore thumb So what we decided to do was release Come Get to This as the first single from the compilation. Bam, it hit. So with the record being as hot as it was in the top 23 on the urban contemporary charts, I immediately ran in the studio and cut an album called Get to This.
Stepping out, gonna have so much fun.
If a movie is done, L.J. Reynolds would have so much control in the movie until I would determine on what I would sing and whether it's the soundtrack or not. But to answer your question, I still sang all the songs that I've sang in my 20s. I still sang them in the same key today. So not only could I sing them, but I could sing them better.
I feel so great about it that I think that the world needs to see the Dramatics for who they are and what they are.
Oh, without a doubt. Now, you know what? I'm glad that you said we're going to do it, you know, because you're claiming it, and that's what you have to do. Ooh, ooh.
Let's be honest. We just do what we do, and we're glad to do it and glad the opportunity to have it done. It was definitely a dream come true. And it's a wonderful thing to be living your dream.
I don't regret nothing. There's a lot of ways of making it in this business. Who's to say that if I hadn't got with the Dramatics that I would have made it? I think I would have, because that's the mindset that I'm in and that I was always in, and I would record records and eventually you'll get a hit. If you keep playing the lottery and you stay alive long enough, you might get.
Well, what the public what the public demands of the Dramatics, that level of quality.
I love it. As I told my kids, if I had to go back in life, I wouldn't have done it any other way.
Ron Banks' last performance, which will be on the upcoming Dramatics album that I put together called Bad Girl. And that's also go to MotorCityHits.com.
Thank you.
I appreciate it.
God bless.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Welcome, welcome, welcome. Now, how long has it been since you had a friend? Who loved you? Who really?